Welcome to my channel. My name is Alice and my channel's name is Where is Alice? Today I'm in Norway. I'm gonna try to hike up the second highest mountain in Norway and in Northern Europe, I think. Come along. So this mountain, it's called the Glitretind. There's two ways to get up there, or well, two like real ways that it's marked tracks. One is from Splitterstulen, where I were 2 days ago and climbed up the highest mountain, and then you can walk from Glitterheim. If a Norwegian person is watching this, I'm sorry, I'm not that good with language and accents. That's where I'm gonna walk from, and that's a way shorter walk. But I think it's like more beautiful. I don't know. We'll find out.
Om du har tröttnat på Sudoku.
Ja, vi snackar om det. Vi sa till mig med jag hemliga meddelande.
Du har hem till någon som du inte känner. Ta sönder något värdefullt och stå kvar.
Ja, och sen börjar du ursäkta.
Ja, precis. Och så se om du kan snacka ur situationen. Ja, i vilket fall som helst.
Now I arrived at the parking lot. The parking lot is free, so you can stand here as long as you want, I think. But you have to pay a fee to drive on this road so they can keep it maintained. But the road is like super beautiful all the way from the start till here. It's beautiful all the way, so even if you're not gonna hike, I recommend driving on the road because it's and so many spots that you can stop and put up your tent or sleep in your car and just relax and have a good time, you know. Here, if you want to, you can hire bicycles. It costs 100 kronas to go one way and then 100 to go back. I don't have that much money and I like walking. I love bicycling, but I don't. I could take my bicycle. I have a little bicycle in my car, but it's too much of a dirt road, I think. Maybe I should. Maybe it was a woman over here. I'm gonna ask her. Yes, I managed to ask her. She was even Swedish, so it was all good, speaking Swedish and not Norwegian. Apparently it is this kind of dirt road for like 7 kilometers, so I'm gonna take my little bike. Let's just say, if you are gonna do this, maybe you should have a bike with gears, or maybe a bike with at least bigger wheels. That was kind of a workout for me, a big warm-up. So it's currently 10 o'clock. Way later than what I thought it would be. So we'll see how melted the snow is when I get up there. And also this hut, they had this skjortlapp, you know, these ones, so you can slide on the snow. Kind enough to borrow one or lend me one. Oh, it's too heavy to walk and talk. Okay, see you later. So far this track is way easier than to go up on Galdhøpiggen. It's like slowly going upwards. So one thing you do kind of need to know, that I didn't know, is that it's pretty much only in the beginning that you can get a really good water. I filled up my water bottle a little bit higher up, and I don't know if I really supposed to drink it because I was... I think this is the longest slope toboggan. It's called that sliding on the snow slope I've seen. You can see people sliding down, and then you gotta walk and come back over here. You see two dots right there? I'm just feeling how my energy is super low right now. And it's not that challenging, so I think it's time for lunch. But guys, speaking of sliding on the snow, when I was an exchange student in New Zealand, my friends were like, oh, let's go tobogganing, or whatever they did call it. And I was like, it is summer. It's the green grass. And then we went, they were like, oh yeah, but you can do it on the grass. And we tied this sliding thing behind four-wheel driving thing. And then we drove around. Oh, that was so much fun. Shout out to you guys if you're watching. Good times. Good times. You know how I said that this is like the biggest slide I've ever seen on snow? I see people that are there, but I honestly don't think, like, now I can see almost the whole thing and it looks like quite a big glacier, and you're not really supposed to walk on glaciers unless you know what you're doing. So maybe they do know what they're doing, but we'll see when I get up there what it looks like. I can really feel how my energy is up on the go again. Guys, I think I can see the top. I think that's the top. It is beautiful out here, up here. Just check this place out. I think I'm soon at the top. And the snow is not that soft that I suspected it to be. Guys, I am super soon up on the top. Not at all as crowded as the other one. What is it called? Galdhøpiggen. And I still don't know how to pronounce it. Ta-da! Yes! I always feel super awkward recording amongst people, so I might not have expressed my whole inner feeling for you guys on the top about this sliding down the slope. It was like a children family that I met, and I see that they are down there now, and they did not have any extra equipment or stuff like that. So I found some track down the snow. Vroom! All the way down. And I'm just thinking, if they have gone here, then I should be fine. I hope I don't die. I guess that if you're watching this video, I'm still alive, so you know that this is gonna be a happy ending right now. Yeah, it's gonna be fun! That was, holy moly, that was so much fun. It's the number one pulkabacke, whatever that is in English. This has actually been the most empty route I have done these last few days. So this time I was more alone, which I really like, because when I'm alone, I really want to be super alone so I can be with my own thoughts. But if I see other people and they're having fun together, I'm like, oh, they're having so much fun and I'm alone. But if I'm totally alone, all good. I really, really enjoy it. So today has been a super duper good day, but it's not done yet. That was one of the easiest downhills I've been walking. But down there, we got the hut. Now let's bike back. I was planning to take a shower here, but I just figured out that I don't have any clean clothes with me, and also I will probably get sweaty when I'm biking my way back, unless I bike really slowly. So never mind, just got a shower later. Let's bike. We made it. Back and go, so my glasses are back on. It feels really nice. And my feet smells horrible. I've used the same socks for 3 days now, so. And now I'm starting to get really cold and I really need to swim, take a swim, because I've been sweating a lot, so I really need to do it. And my feet smelt, like I said. So, but I'm just gonna do it. Don't think, just do it, just do it. And then the mosquito invasion came. I made myself some dinner because I'm starving. We got some pasta with red linses, fresh tomatoes, and cucumber, and what is called spinach. Yeah, you know what I mean. Ooh, can you hear the rain? That's so cozy. Oh no, my bikini. Oh well, it's already so wet, so... No, my shoes! Hold on. Now it's fine. Please like this video if you liked it. Because that makes me really happy. And subscribe if you want to follow more adventure. Oof, it's real cold, I'm freezing. I need to put on more clothes. So while I put on more clothes, subscribe. And also like I'm way more active on Instagram, so make sure to follow me there, and like my stories, I put up my story quite often. Bye.